G'day, Chris here and welcome back to Clickspring. In this video, I go through the steps for cutting the wheels. Despite the range of sizes for the wheels on this clock, for the most part, they're all made in essentially the same way. As to why clockmakers call gears wheels, I haven't really found a good answer. But if it has 20 or more teeth, it's called a wheel, and if it has less than 20, it's called a pinion. Now, rather than show the cutting of all the wheels for this clock, which I thought might be a bit tedious, I'm going to cover the process for this 144 tooth wheel as a representation of all of them. And then later in the video, I'll show the differences for the others. So let's get into it. Starting out with a sheet of 1/16 inch engraver's brass, I've lightly marked the centre and then roughed out a blank. You're going to see me use these super glue arbors a lot as I make this clock. They're perfect for holding work pieces that need to be machined on the edges. The face of the chuck can be trued up if required. A little glue is applied. And then the rough blank is held in place with the tailstock for a few minutes while it sets. It's sort of the modern version of the shellac wax chuck that watchmakers have traditionally used. I turn the blank to the correct outside diameter and then drilled and bored the hole to the correct size. So I need to be able to divide the work and also make the cuts to form the teeth. And there are probably as many ways to do this as there are lathes, but this is how I do it. I made an adapter plate for a myford vertical slide to fit the cross slide, and also a platform that'll hold the motor and speed control. A spindle is mounted on the vertical slide, and then it's indicated to be square. The cutter is mounted on an arbor, and then it's locked into the spindle. And then it's lined up on the center of the work. In this case, I'm using a centering button to identify the wheel center. And finally, the belt needs to be tensioned so that it's tight at the full depth of cut. And that's the cutting setup all ready to go. Now for dividing, I have these classic dividing plates, but the 290 tooth great wheel is a bit of a problem. I don't have a dividing plate to cover that particular tooth count, and I guess I could have made one, but it was just the excuse I've been waiting for to invest in a new toy, a digital indexer. I had to make a few bits and pieces to make it work for my setup, like this expanding mandrel for the rear of the lathe, as well as supporting brackets, but this stuff only needs to be made once, and then it's good to go for the future. So this is how the dividing mechanism fits onto my lathe. And I know I'm totally spoiled with this, but it really simplifies the job. I can move forwards or backwards without having to think too hard, and I can now get any tooth count that I want. Okay, now after all that setup, let's finally cut some teeth. The first step is to establish the correct depth of cut. And to do this, I took repeated cuts on either side of a single tooth, slightly lowering the cutter after each pass. The idea is to keep increasing the depth of cut until the blue in the middle just disappears. At that point, the cutter is at the correct depth to form the teeth. The vertical slide is then locked, and then all of the teeth are cut in one pass. After all of the setup, the actual cutting of teeth is pretty straightforward. The wheel can be taken off with a bit of heat, and each wheel is essentially cut the same way, although there are a few slight differences in each case. Firstly, the superglue arbors. There is no arbor required for the brass pinions. I cut those from rod stock, so they're easy. And here's the arbor for the stop work wheels. These teeth are a little long, so I made this one thicker and just machined it away along with the brass to keep the teeth well supported during the cutting. Same goes for the escape wheel. The centre wheel arbor is fabricated from two parts, as is the arbor for the great wheel. Apart from size, it's essentially the same thing in each case. Some wheels require different profile cutters, the escape wheel for instance, and the ratchet. And there are no commercial cutters available to make the stop work wheels. They have a rather large tooth pitch, so require a custom cutter. I made this button tool to cut the tooth profile, and this arbor to hold it in the spindle. And here's the finished cutter, hardened and tempered. Other than those differences, it's pretty much the same for each wheel. In the next video, I'll tackle the two hardened steel pinions. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. And if you're new to Clickspring, welcome. I post regular videos on machining and clockmaking, so if home machining is your thing, hit that subscribe button and I'll see you on the next video.